Hey, what's going on people? It's Bro, hope you're doing well, and in this video I'm going to explain how stages work in JavaFX, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you wouldn't mind, please like, comment, and subscribe. One like equals one prayer for the YouTube algorithm. Welcome one and all. In this video we're going to be focusing on stages. When I mean stage, I'm referring to the stage of a theater or play in that context. It's like the stage you performed on during your school's talent show your junior year and you embarrassed yourself in front of the entire school. Good times. A stage is a top-level container to hold our FX GUI applications. It's similar to a J-frame in Swing. In layman's terms, it's basically our window, so to speak. So in this video, we'll be customizing our stage in FX. Let's begin by creating a new FX project. If you need to set up your IDE to accommodate FX, please watch the previous videos in the series. Let's create a new project. I'm using the Eclipse IDE. If you're using IntelliJ IDEA, you'll have a different process, but I covered these processes in the previous videos. So let's go to File, New, Project, JavaFX Project. Call this project whatever you want. I'll call this Hello FX. Finish. Then if I were to open this project, a lot of these objects are not recognized. So we just need to make sure that we add our FX library. To do that, right click on your project folder, go to Build Path, Add Libraries, User Library, Next, JavaFX, and Finish. And then we'll just want to be sure that we have our VM arguments or options if you're using IntelliJ set up. So right click on your project folder, go to Run As, Run Configurations, Arguments, and then make sure you have your VM arguments set up, and then you can run if you want to. Now this is our FX GUI. It's composed of different layers, a stage, a scene graph, and various nodes. It's like a GUI sandwich made of different layers. Let's break it all down layer by layer. Let's begin with the stage. The stage is a top-level container. Think of it as a window, the window for your application. It's very similar to a J-frame in Swing. Our next layer is a scene. We add a scene to the stage, and a scene is a drawing surface for graphical content, similar to a J-panel in Swing. Next, we have a scene graph. This is a hierarchical tree of nodes. It's a tree data structure to hold and arrange what are called nodes. And nodes are all the different components that we add to a scene. These can be buttons, text boxes, images, and they are arranged in a tree, a hierarchical tree, beginning with a root node. There's branch nodes and leaf nodes, but we'll cover this in a future video. You should just be aware that they're out here. But we at least need a root node to create a scene, and then we add a scene to the stage. Let's head back to our FX application. Currently, a lot of the work is already done for us, and that kind of defeats the purpose of learning how this works. So, for learning purposes, let's delete all of this content within the main class, except for the main method, but we will clear the main method. Okay, currently, our main method extends the application class. The application class is the parent class, and our main class is the child class. So the main class is going to inherit everything that the application class has. So in order for this program to work, since the application class is the parent class, there is an abstract method that we need to inherit and to override. So we can just add unimplemented methods. So in order for this program to run, our main class needs a start method, and in order to call the start method, it's actually done behind the scenes. What we do is call the launch method first within our main method, and when we call the main method, when we begin this program, we receive a string array of what we call arguments, and we just need to send our launch method these arguments. The launch method is a static method that belongs to the application class, and since our main class is a child class of the application class, we inherit this method. And since this is a static method, you could write it as it is currently, or you can write it as application.launch as well, but let's just keep it as we have before. So the launch method is a static method that we inherit from the application parent class, and when you call the launch method, we will send our string array of arguments to the launch method, and eventually, behind the scenes, our start method will automatically be called. The first thing that we're going to do is to create a stage, and when we call the start method, we actually receive a stage already. With what we had previously before I deleted everything, This was called primary stage. You can either use this, you can name it whatever you want too, or we can create our own stage. So if you need to create another stage, just follow these steps. Stage, come up with a name for the stage, I'll call it stage, equals new stage. All right, but since we already have a stage, I'm just going to use that. And I will rename this as stage to keep things simple. So we currently have a stage, but if I were to run this, we can't actually see the stage. So at the end of the start method, we're going to use stage.show to show the stage. So you want to be sure to keep this at the end of the start method. So now if I were to run this, we can actually see the stage, but we'll probably want to customize this. You can see that it's kind of funky with the colors right now. So that's because we need to add a scene to the stage. That's the next layer. Let's add a scene. Scene, and we'll call the scene equals new scene. And in order to construct a scene, we need to add at least a root node. We'll pass in a root node as an argument to the constructor of the scene class. But there are various different types of root nodes. Think of them like layout managers. They will dictate how our nodes, our components, whether they're images, text boxes, buttons, are arranged within a scene. But each different type of root node would take me an entire video on explaining how they work and how they arrange the nodes. So let's create a very basic type of root node called a group. Think of it as a grouping of nodes. And what people usually do for their root node, they will just call this root. Group root equals new group. And we'll need to import something. So make sure you're importing the correct import from javafx.scene. These other ones will probably not work. So once you have that import, we can add the root node to the scene. And then we'll add the scene to the stage. So at the end, before we show the stage, we will set the scene. Stage.setScene. And we will pass in our scene. So in summary, what we're doing is creating a root node to arrange all of the different nodes that we have, our components, adding the root node to the scene, adding the scene to the stage, and then at the end, we'll show the stage. Kind of like it's a play. You gotta set the scene before you present the stage. This time, if I were to run this application with our window, our stage that we have, we now have a scene added to the stage. And do you remember before how we had just a stage? Well, the background on the stage was kind of funky. It was white and black, and that would change as we resized our stage that we have. Well, now we have a scene added to the stage, and our scene is going to resize automatically when we resize the stage. And we can change the appearance of our stage and scene as well. So let's set the background color of our scene. We can pass in a color to the constructor of our scene when we create one. So let's say color dot and pick a color, maybe black. So you'll probably need this import as well. Make sure you get the right one, because if you get the wrong import, then this will probably not work. So now the background of my scene will be black, and then you can resize this as well, and the scene will adjust accordingly to the size of the stage. Let's set a title for the stage. Stage.setTitle, and we can pass in a string for what we want the title to be. Stage demo program. Woot woot! All right, so now with our stage, we should now have a title at the top. Stage demo program, woot woot. Let's change the icon in the top left corner of my stage. Currently, it's some sort of lame box, so let's change that. So I would like to change that icon to the logo of my channel. So what I'm going to do is copy my file, then go to my source folder, and then paste it. So with FX, FX will begin looking for any images within your source folder. With Swing, it was your project folder. So when you paste it, make sure it's within your source folder. And then I need to make an image out of my file that I have. So what I'm going to do is type image, and maybe I'll call this icon. Image icon equals new image. And then I'm going to list my file name and or the file path if it's someplace else. Since this is within my source folder, I only need to list the file name. And this is icon.png. Now, this is probably going to be something different for you depending on what you named your file. And then make sure you get the right import. You're looking for import image javafx.scene.image. And then we can add this icon to my stage that I have. So that'll be the next line. stage.getIcons, follow this with dot add icon. And let's give it a try. There we go. The image that I have is now the icon of my stage. And if you have a menu bar at the bottom, this will probably change that too. Here's a few other useful methods. One, we can set the width and the height of our stage. Stage.setWidth, and pick whatever width you want. Maybe 420, because 420 is a funny number. And I'll set the height too, to the same number. Set height. And this should change the size of our stage. However, this is still resizable. You can disable that if you need to. Stage.setResizable, and we will pass in false. Therefore, we should no longer be able to resize this stage. You can see that I'm trying, but I really can't. We can set the X position and Y position of where our stage will appear within our computer screen. We have to use setX and setY. Normally with FX, FX will place your stage in the middle of your computer screen, which is convenient. Swing doesn't normally do that. And let's say stage.setY, and we'll set this to 50. So my stage is now going to appear in the top left corner of my computer screen, well, approximately. And my stage now appears in the top left corner. So let me disable that for now and turn those lines into comments. Oh, you guys are going to like this next one. We can set our stage to be full screen using the setFullScreen method. And we just need to pass in true. So when you run this application, your stage is now going to be full screen. And if you need to escape, just press escape to exit full screen mode. And then if you need to change the exit hint as well as the exit key combination, normally by default it is escape. You can change that if you need to. Let's begin by changing the exit screen hint. So stage.setFullScreenExitHint. So what do we want this to display? You can't escape unless you press Q. And let's change the exit key combination as well. Stage.setFullScreenExitKeyCombination. And then as an argument, we need to pass in keyCombination.value of, and let's say Q. Lowercase q. All right, let's test this. You can't escape unless you press Q. I'm going to press Q to escape. All right, everybody, so that's the basics of stages in JavaFX. If you would like a copy of all this, I will post all of this in the comments down below and pin it to the top. But yeah, that's how stages work in JavaFX. Hey, you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learned something new, then help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.